migrated from Mexico to the United States when I was 6.5 years old. I think I turned 7 here. I still remember the day that I came in a Friday. My dad had everything squared out. Like, he had it all planned out. We went to church that Sunday. It was all English. I had no idea what the priest was talking about. But because I'm Catholic, I know the routines and everything, so I was able to do some of that stuff. And then Monday, here we go to a school. In Mexico, I went to school with my siblings from
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to let you know that we are indeed going to get this game underway, but we're going to be about 15 minutes later than what was originally set. We said 6:30 for a start time. However, because the game had originally been set up to be starting at 7:30, the National Park Ladies Program, they have canceled the remainder of their season. So we would have normally started the evening at 5:30. They did away with that, and they moved the men's game up to 6:30. However, the officials, apparently there was a mix-up with the officials. They will not be here until 6:45. So we're going to visit back in with Maricela and find out why she wants to be a teacher, and we will get this game underway momentarily here on ed88radio.com.
p.m. to 6 p.m., and then we walked to our school. We carried our little lunch bag. And then we come to a school where we have to get up early. I have to go in this big yellow bus, which I was afraid of. Not only that, but I get car sick, so you can imagine. I struggled for quite a bit. And then you come to a school where you can't communicate with your teachers. You can't communicate with your friends. At that time, the Hispanics that were at the week schools at that time were on the same boat that I was. We really couldn't help each other on the translating or interpreting because they were either just 1 year ahead of me at the school or just got in like me. So I do remember myself sleeping through the classroom. The only thing I knew to do was math, which I think that's universal numbers. Translate to all languages, I think. So I was able to do math. Other than that, I think I slept through the whole thing because poor teachers, they didn't know how to go about helping me or me communicating with them. So it was a struggle. It was very different, culture shocking. I learned that we get breakfast in the morning, and then we get lunch, and then we get to go home. So I wasn't used to that. I was used to carrying my own lunch, whatever I like, and now I'm having to eat this different food, different taste, and it was some difficult times. I could not mingle with my classmates as much because of the language barrier. Once again, we couldn't communicate. So I remember sitting myself back on a bench or somewhere in a corner, just watching everybody do their thing. And here I am crying because I was crying. I was separated from my siblings. They all went to different classrooms, different buildings. And then here I am by myself. And so I felt really, really bad. But in the long run, here I am. I'm a teacher now and I'm in the ESL program position. So, how I wanted to be a teacher, or how I got to this place, is I think to be somebody, you, in my opinion anyway, you are born with something. And in my situation, I feel I was born to be a teacher. Whether it was in Mexico or here or anywhere, I think I was born to be a teacher. I was born to help others. And since I was little and I can remember, everything and all I did was related to education. So I worked really, really hard in understanding the language. Once again, back in the day, there weren't a lot of resources for the Hispanic kids like me. I had to really learn a lot of stuff, and I don't think teachers, colleges knew exactly how to go about with students like me on helping them find what they needed. So I had to do a lot of research and asking around, and I don't think Googling at that time. I don't remember if we had Googled at that time. Probably did. I'm not that old though. But just the struggle to be where I'm at was not an easy path. But I have always said that easy is not always the best. If you struggled, you value more your struggle, your path. And I think I'm at that point. My path to where I'm at right now was not as easy, but I know it's not as hard as others. But thanks to all that, I am where I'm at. Thanks to my parents that brought me here. At that time, when I was 6.5 years old, I did not understand why I had to leave everything behind, family, home, everything, school, everything, and come to a place where I had no idea what it was about. To me, it was like moving from Earth to another planet. So I resented my parents for a good long 4 years, I think, because I felt they brought me without asking, without giving us a heads up of what's going to happen. Or if they did, I was so little, I do not remember. But now I thank them. I thank them for what they did, because now at my hometown is probably not the best place to be right now because of all the stuff going around. But I feel safe in this country. I feel free, and I feel independent. All the struggles that I went through are worth it, because now I can value all that struggle and do what I want to do, which is to be a teacher, to work with kids, to work with the community. Now I am bilingual, and I can use those skills to help others. Kids, adults, whoever needs me, I'm there to help. So I value all of that stuff. And once again, how I got here, I think I always wanted to be a teacher, and I worked hard for that. It wasn't easy, but if you have perseverance, if you work hard for what you want, you can always do it. So all you have to do is dream it, work for it, and then you can make it. Language barrier is not a problem, no more. If you make that as an excuse, I'm gonna say no. Language barrier is not a problem. It's all in your head. It's all in your heart. It's what you want for yourself. So if you want to succeed in life, and you want to succeed in a good way, work hard, because things are not going to be placed in front of you and make it easy. They're going to be hard. And the hard path is always the best. The easy path, probably not.
Your season of life, you'll find the financial products, digital tools, and friendly service that make you feel right at home with Farmers Bank. Come home to Farmers Bank.
UACASITAT is launching a brand new aerial lineman training course. This 145-hour clock hour course will offer training in broadband essentials and aerial lineman communications, with graduates receiving a career training work-ready certificate. The median yearly income for a communications aerial lineman in America is over $60,000, and the industry will need an average of 10,000 new linemen each year for the next 10 years. The UAC Aerial Lineman course will have you job ready in just 4 weeks, and qualifying participants pay zero tuition. We have the trucks, we have the poles, We have the equipment and the classroom. All we need is you. To find out more, check us out online at www.cccua.edu or call 870-584-1178 or email continuingeducation@cccua.edu. Come train at the college that bestcolleges.com ranks as the number one community college in the state, University of Arkansas, Casa Todd.
Good evening and welcome to the historic Bank of Locksburg Gymnasium in Locksburg on the campus of UA Casa Todd, on our industrial campus here in Locksburg. And I just noticed a moment ago in looking at the feed for this ball game tonight. First of all, I want to thank everybody on board. Looks like we have a good crowd checking in tonight on a rainy night across southwest Arkansas. Glad we're able to get this ball game in. I know National Park, the Nighthawks were unable to play their last game. What, ASU Newport? That game didn't happen. The Colts have had a game that has been postponed as well. We were supposed to take on the ASU Mid-South team last week, but that didn't happen because of all this wintertime weather. I'll be honest with you, I don't know how they have sports in places like Michigan and Wisconsin, Minnesota. Anyway, here on the campus of UA Costa, coming up next week, or actually I guess it's February 1st, we're going to have a special day set aside to honor our first ever aerial lineman class. And going to have a number of dignitaries on hand, as well as representatives from industry that are looking for aerial linemen. There's a big demand for that now, what with all the various data services, many of which are transferred over lines that are, well, they're overhead lines. So anyway, to fill that need, UA Costot set up an aerial lineman program this year. And if you're interested, contact us here at UA Costot. We'll let you know more about it. Looking forward to tonight's game. It's not very often you get to sit and watch the number one team in America play basketball, but that's exactly what we're doing tonight. National Park Junior College, the Nighthawks come in 15-0 on the season, undefeated and ranked number one in the latest Division II college rankings. And they have like five different guys averaging in double figures, led by Jabriant Hill. And Hill is just one of several outstanding basketball players on this team. I said Jabriant Hill. Actually, I guess it was Jabriant Hill's averaging 16 points a game. Dakavian White actually leads the way with over 18 points a game. And White is ranked as the number five junior college basketball player in America by JUCO. What is that? According to JUCORecruiting.com. And he's a good one. And he's just one of several on this basketball team. Also averaging in double figures for the Nighthawks, Patrick Punch, who, by the way, was last week's Region 2, Division 2 Player of the Week. He had 36 points last week against South Arkansas. But Punch is another one of their fine players, averaging in double figures. You got Kareem Collins averaging 12 points per game. And coming off the bench, Sadiq Canty, averaging about 10 points per game. So it's a talented basketball team, 2-0 in conference play, and they're ranked highly in several different categories, including, well, they're inside the top 10 in a number of categories. They are the third leading team in the country in assists per game, so they do pass the basketball around a lot. Fifth in the country in steals per game, number seven in the country in blocked shots per game. They're ranked sixth in the country in field goal percentage, eighth in the country in field goals made per game, and they're 13th, well, actually 10th in the country in defensive rebounds per game and 13th in rebound margin per game. So it's a talented basketball team, and we actually have one of our local kids that play for them, Will Dykes. And I remember watching Will playing high school basketball and junior high basketball at DeQueen Schools. And Will comes from a long line of athletes in the Dykes family. But Will was a guard, a point guard at one point in his life because he was, I don't know, knee-high to a grasshopper at that time. But he caught a growth spurt about his junior year. He's 6'5". He still has all those skills, but he's the backup center now for the Nighthawks. Anyway, so much, a very talented basketball team. And We've been playing National Park for a number of years, even back before we were an NJCAA school. UACassetat, our first year of basketball, we were basically just playing club basketball. And went to, I guess our first basketball game, we went to Hot Springs, played National Park, did not come away with a victory. It was a long night to say the least, but at that point, Chancellor Dr. Steve Cole said, you know, that's what we want to be. We want to pattern our program after that. And we've made some strides. National Park is, as a native Arkansan, I certainly take great pride in the fact they are ranked number one in the country. Love to see them get upset tonight, though, all right? Anyway, we're still about 7.5 minutes away from the start of tonight's game. Got a decent crowd on hand for a rainy, drizzly night after all the weather we've had this week. I think people are just glad to get out. And like I say, the original start time, originally this game was supposed to be at 7:30, but with the cancellation of the remainder of the Lady Nighthawks basketball season, the men's game was moved up to 6:30. Unfortunately, the officiating crew didn't get the memo, and they're here right now. I think all three of the officials are here. So we're not too far away, but they're making a start time at around 6:45. So anyway, we're going to take a quick break, be back with more as the Colts get set to take on the Nighthawks here on ed88radio.com.
It's new Coca-Cola Zero Sugar. Is it the best Coke ever?
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
Okay, I'm going to try it first.
Yes!
I need to try it first.
Casatot Colts merchandise is now available at the ERCs in Dequeen, Ashdown, and Nashville. Come on in and let our friendly staff show you around. We have a lot to choose from, including t-shirts in a variety of styles and colors, caps, hoodies, polos, long sleeve t-shirts. We have joggers and stuff like coffee mugs and insulated thermal tumblers, as well as flash drives, lanyards, and power bank chargers. Just let the staff know what you need.
I'm Barbara Dixon, and this is Anna Belcher, and we're with Southern Bancorp Bank. Southern is a different kind of bank. We are a designated community development financial institution, and our main focus, our mission, is to be involved in and serve the community. And what makes us different is we offer traditional banking services, but we also offer other services that help strengthen our community to teach them financial literacy and to help them to build credit, understand credit, and to make good, wise choices. Some of the programs we offer, we have a learning center that covers everything from savings to loans to small business, housing. There's also a section of that website that is designated for youth that's broken up by age groups, so you can get financial literacy information for your children on that website. There's a section for senior citizens as well. We also offer free credit review. We will help you pull your free credit report, go over it with you, give you the resources to review it and to know what to look for. We offer a credit builder CD loan to help you start building credit history or to improve your credit history. We also offer free counseling services, whether you want to just do a budget or just ask questions. That service is free, and it's all free to customers and non-customers alike. We offer free home ownership counseling services. We offer free income tax preparation through the VITA program. It's a voluntary income tax preparation assistance program. And for consumers who qualify, we prepare their taxes free. We will be doing that right here in the Larkspur branch. A lot of what Southern does is they try to strengthen the community, the businesses and individuals alike. And we are considered, one of our models is to be wealth builders for everyone. And one of the primary ways we start that is by teaching savings habits. And Anna is going to tell you a little bit about some of those.
We have a few savings products that's going on right now. One is our Roundup Savings. Every time you use your debit card, you can either round up to the next dollar amount, or you can round up a certain dollar, whether it's one or five, just whatever is convenient for you. And we also have what is called an app that you can download, and the app is called Envy. And it is a savings game. It's 100 days process, and you determine how much you want to save in 100 days. And every day that you go into the app, you open the envelope, and it may transfer a dollar, it may transfer $2. Whatever is in that envelope on that app that day is how much it transferred to your savings account. We also have what we call a CD credit builder loan. If you are just starting out and getting credit, or you've just graduated from school and you're having a hard time getting credit because you have no credit score, or even if you've had past negative credit, then you can come in and we can start you out with credit of a CD loan, and that also gives you a CD. When you pay your loan off, that CD is your money. And Southern believes in Sevier County. We believe in empowering our community, and we are thankful to be here in Sevier County, and we look forward to serving Sevier County and the people in this community for years to come.
My parents are feeding us boring chicken again.
Mobilize all units.
I worry about my little sister.
Put that down, sir. Step away from the microwave. Pilgrim's Chicken. Try it today. It'll kick the boring right out of you.
Well, it's game time here at the Bank of Locksmore Historic Gymnasium. We're going to turn things over to our PA announcer now, John Bunyer, for the starting lineup. Hey, Janet.
Sophomore guard, receiver, Patrick Hodge. Sophomore guard, Julie, Jordan, Hill. Sophomore forward, Ty, Kim, and Jack. And sophomore
Our starting lineups. We're set to get underway. National Park comes in 2-0 in conference play, 15-0 on the season. Colts 1-1. Colts 4-3 on their home court. And we're facing a serious test tonight. Colts have two players averaging in double figures. As the opening tip is controlled by the Nighthawks with the ball into the front court. That's Jabriant Hill. Hill works it up top in the hands of Kervin Collins. Working it down low. Strong move on the basket. Turnaround shot put up and in by Taylor Harrell. Harrell gets the first two of the night. Nighthawks up 2-0. Colts have it in the front court. Kevon Wally, leading scorer for the Colts, coming in averaging 16 points a game. Nice give. Backdoor play won't go. Dylan Glover's shot picked up and brought the other way by Nikavion White. And a whistle. The Colts will have it. They'll bring it the other way. Trailing 2-0 as we're just underway here at the Bank of Lochsburg Historic Gymnasium. Tonight's broadcast being brought to you by Coca-Cola of Southwest Arkansas, by Pilgrims, and by McDonald's. Colts have it on the right wing. Nick Moyer with it. Works it out on the wing. Glover back over to Moyer for three. Off the back of the iron, no good. The rebound chased down by the Nighthawks. Loose ball scooped around, picked up by Moyer for the Colts. Colts have it in the front court. Out to Wally. Kevon works it right side to Glover. Dylan gives it back left side to Kevon. Three-pointer can't get it to go down. The rebound fought for. And out battling Loggins for the rebound will be Nikavion White. Driving down low, laying it off the glass with a left hand. Taylor Horrell. Harrell has four. And the Colts trail it 4-0. Wally across the horsey head. Out beyond the key. Gets it left side. Into hands of Moyer. Back over to Dylan Glover. Lost it off his shin. Colts down to 10 seconds on the shot clock. In the corner. Kahari Loggins had it stripped away and then stripped it right back again, but the ball goes out of bounds. Last touched by the Colts. Good defensive play that time on the part of Corinne Collins. Jabriant Hill will walk it across the timeline. 18 minutes to go here in this first half. Nighthawks on top, 4-0. Jabriant Hill works right side. Shot on the way from the corner. Three-pointer no good. The rebound's going to be hauled down by Loggins. Kahari on the run. Drives. Oh, nice give underneath. Demaje Hampton puts it up and in, and the Colts are on the scoreboard. Hampton gets his first two. 4-2. 17 and a half minutes to play. First half. Collins has it. Oh, nice give underneath. Shot put up no good, but a whistle and a foul underneath. Flashing to the basket that time. Is that White? I think that was Nikavion White taking it to the basket. No, that was not. Excuse me, that's going to be Patrick Punch. Punch will head to the free throw line. Personal foul was called on Demaje Hampton. It's his first team foul against the Colts. At the free throw line, bounces around and it won't go down. Punch will have another one coming here as he was fouled in the act of shooting. Colts trail it 4-2, 17 and a half minutes to play first half. Punches second shot, puts it on the way, and rattles around and goes in. 5-2, Colts down by three. Wally brings it into the front court. Drives down low, puts it up. Oh, nice move from the left side. Good upper body strength on the part of Kevon Wally. Colts point guard gets his first two. Colts trail it 5-4. Nighthawks have it. Working it around the perimeter. Jabrian Hill. Hill works it back up top to punch. They get it down low. And pound it back out way out front. Three-pointer on the way. Knocking it down from way outside to Bryant Hill. Actually, a different Nighthawk started to grab it, then realized that's actually for Hill. Step back, and Hill got the basket. As Kevon Wally goes up for the shot, he's going to be fouled in the act of shooting. He's heading to the free throw line to shoot a pair. Personal foul is going to be on Collins. Corrin called for his first team foul against the Nighthawks. Colts will head to the free throw line. Kevon Wally, his first trip to the charity stripe tonight. Colts trail it, 8-4. And Wally's first free throw is off the back of the iron, no good. .16:38 left in this first half. Colts trail it, 8-4. Second shot on the way, good. Wally has three. And the Colts trail by three. Into the front court. That's Patrick Punch. Goes around the screen, gives it right back, and the ball is tipped away by Demaje Hampton. He gives it to Loggins. Gahari gives it ahead to Wally, and Q will bring it into the front court. Kevon works around the screen, drives down low, tries the right side this time, gets it underneath to Loggins inside the lane. Kissed it off the glass and good. Loggins, nice basket that time. He gets his first two. Loggins has really come on over the last several games. As the Nighthawks fired up from outside, shot inside the arc up and in. Patrick Punch knocks it down. Colts trail it, 10-7. Wally backs it back out, tries to tie it up with a three, can't get it to go, and the rebound is going to be picked up by the Nighthawks, Nikavian White. And we'll have a whistle on the drive. Personal foul is going to be called. It's a blocking foul called against the Colts. Dylan Glover called for the personal foul. That's going to send Nikavian White to the free throw line. Nikavian puts that shot up and in. White, his first point of the night. Nighthawks, 2 out of 3 at the free throw line. He'll have another one coming here. So the Nighthawks lead at 11-7 with 15:40 to play in this first half. White takes his time, sends it on the way, puts it in. Nikavian with a couple of points. Colts trail it by 5, 12-7. 15:30 to go, first half. Kevon Wally tries that right side. Goes baseline, kicks it back out in the hands of Moye. Looking to get some room out there, gets it back out. To Wally, 12 seconds on the shot clock as Wally backs it back out. Has the ball tipped away, picked right back up by Demaje Hampton. Has his momentum broken as he headed to the basket, but managed to knock it down. He found a big old roadblock out there in the form of the Taylor Harrell. But Hampton got the shot to go down. He's got four. Shot put up and in. Three-pointer put up and in. And Nikavian White with a three, he's got five. Colts trail at 15-9. They'll work it over to Kevon Wally. Wally deep in that left corner, fires it back out to Dylan Glover. Glover tries to penetrate, lost the handle momentarily, fires it back out to Wally. 6 seconds on the shot clock, deep in the corner. Glover catch and release, can't get the shot to go down, and the rebound going to be pulled down by White. Nikavian drives through the lane. Shot is blocked by Demaje Hampton. Late whistle. Personal foul is going to be on Demaje Hampton. I'm not saying it wasn't a foul, but I thought he might have gotten by with it there for a moment. Heading to the free throw line will be Nikavion White. He's got five, 2 for 2 at the free throw line tonight. National Park on top, 15-9, make it 16-9 as that one's up and in. Nighthawks shooting 4 out of 5 at the free throw line tonight. 14-18 to go first half. National Park on top, 16-9. White, as we said, he's ranked the number 5 junior college player in all of college basketball in America. Shot up and in by White, and the Colts have it, trailing 17-9. Long three-pointer on the way by Dylan Glover. Can't get that one to go. Colts not having any luck from the perimeter as that rebound is going to be pulled down by Anthony Swift. Coming the other way, shot no good. And the Colts have it in the backcourt, whistle and a foul. It looks like Collins is going to be called. Corinne Collins called for the personal foul. That's his second. By the way, in the lineup tonight for the Colts, Zion Harper has checked in the lineup for UA Cassatot. Looks like Kahari Loggins going to get a breather right here. Also checking in, Terry Gupton out of Prescott. As Colts drive it down low as the shot put right back up and in by Zion Harper. Harper gets the basket. That's his first two. As Wally couldn't get the shot to go down, Harper's there to put it back up and in. 17-11. Colts down by 6. Step back. Now they get it back into the left corner. Shot from beyond the three-point arc. No good. The rebound's chased down by Nick Moyer. Moyer out beyond the arc. Right side. Whistle away from the basketball. And Harper's going to be called for a foul away from the basketball. That'll be Harper's first. Fourth team foul against Colts. National Park will have the basketball. They lead it by 6, 17-11. 13-13 to go in this first half. Across the midcourt stripe. Nighthawks give it, looking down on the baseline. Harper's there to steal it away, gets it ahead to Wally. Wally brings it across the midcourt stripe. Out beyond the arc, backs it back out. Fronted out there defensively. As Gupton has it now, drives through the lane, instead gives it right side, 8-footer on the way by Zion Harper, no good, rebound picked up by Gupton, gets it right back out to Glover, brand new shot clock now, as Glover backs it out, goes around the screen by Harper, pulls up for the three, can't get that thing to go, Colts are colder than the weather is outside tonight from beyond the arc, as that rebound goes out of bounds, last touched by the Colts. Colts looking for their first shot from beyond the arc, the first made shot from beyond the arc tonight. Trailing 17-11, National Park has it with 12:15 to play first half. They'll attack the basket, scooping it up from the left side. Shot put up and in by Patrick Punch. He's got 5, Colts down by 8. It's their largest, equals their largest deficit of the night. Harper has it, has his pass tipped away, picked out of the air, finally picked back up by Gupton. He'll get it to Wally. He'll fire up the three. That one's no good. And here come the Nighthawks on the drive. Shot is blocked. And they're going to call Kevon Wally for a foul. No, they didn't. Actually, it's going to be on Glover. I was fixing to say that. I don't think you could really call that one on Kevon. All ball on that one, but yeah, Glover got him. So Dylan Glover's called for his second personal foul, heading to the free throw line for National Park. Will be Collins. Collins at the charity stripe, send it on the wing, good. Corinne's got his first point of the night. National Park taking advantage of their free throw opportunities. They're 6 out of 7 at the free throw line tonight. They lead it 20-11 as Glover comes out of the lineup, and checking in his place will be Jordan Reese. Second shot on the way. It's good. Collins now with 2 points.
On the court right now for the Colts, it's Gufton, Reese, Wally, along with Moye and Harper. Jordan Reese gets it over to Kevon. Dishes off to Moye, lost his footing in the lane, hits the deck, ball goes out of bounds. Colts turn it over. And they're discussing whether they're going to wipe that court up or not. I think they'll let it go for the time being. 11:31 to play. First half, Colts down by 10, 21-11. Nighthawks have it. Jabrian Hill brings it into the front court. Gets it into the hands of White. To Kavion. Now they work it right side for three. Knocking it down from the perimeter. Sadiq Kanti comes off the bench, hits a three. He averages about 10 points a ball game. He's got three of them right now. Colts coming the other way. Down low, Zion Harper. As a little hop, skip, and jump move down there on the baseline, whistling a foul, and that is going to be against Canty. And heading to the free throw line for the Colts will be Zion Harper. Harper has an interesting free throw shooting form here. Watch the little hop here on the free throw. Here we go, and there it is. He actually shoots a jump shot on his free throws. Normally it works. He'll have another one coming here. Colts, by the way, one out of three at the free throw line tonight. Nighthawks are seven out of eight. Harper takes his time, sends it on the way. There's the hop, there's the make. Harper has come off the bench. He's got 3 points. Colts trail it by 12. 24-12. 10:58 to go, first half. Right side punch has it. Patrick, spin move in the lane. Goes up, and a blocking foul is going to be called on Harper. Coach Stan pleading the case here. Harper is going to be called for the personal foul, and that will be his second. Harper's got two. Hampton's got two. Glover with two for the Colts. At the free throw line, Patrick punch. He was the Region 2 Player of the Week last week, but he misses that free throw right there. Punch, one out of three at the free throw line tonight. He's got 5 points in the ball game. Looks like Loggins and Hampton are going to check back in as Harper and Moye check out. So it's Loggins, Wally, Hampton, Gupton, and Reese in the lineup for the Colts, who trail at 24-12. 10:51 to go first half. Second shot, in and out, and then back in again. As Punch has 6 points in the ball game now. And National Park leads it by lucky 13, 25-12. Colts right side, Gupton. He gets it back out front to Loggins, who drives through the lane. Kahari's going to the free throw line. Personal foul is going to be called against number two. That would be Anthony Swift. And at the free throw line, Kahari Loggins. Loggins will shoot a pair. Kahari, first trip to the free throw line tonight. Shot is on the way, and it is good. Loggins with 3 points in the ball game. Colts trail it by a dozen, 25-13, 10:36 to play, first half. Kahari's second shot on the way, and it is good. Loggins with 4 points in the game. Colts within 11. 10.5 to go first half. Swift with it at the free throw line. Gets it in the hands of White. The Kavion shot no good. The rebound's picked up by Loggins. Kahari takes it all the way, lays it up, blows by the defender, but he can't get the shot to go down. Swift grabs the rebound. White has it. The Kavion gives it back into the hands of Jabrian Hill. Hill cut off at the free throw line. Gets it back out to White. He caught punch going through the lane. Couldn't get the shot to go down. Rebound comes off the Colts. Loggins, right side, 14-footer on the way. No good. And the rebound's picked up by Swift. He fires it ahead into punch. Punch gives it back to Swift. And Swift lays it right up and in. Nice fast break that time.
by the Nighthawks. So Swift gets the basket. Give White the assist. Colts have it out beyond the arc. Three-pointer on the way by Reese. Jordan's shot won't go, and the rebound comes off to White. Out-muscled everybody for that. Brought it the other way. Used that long, lanky, muscular frame. Laid it right back up and in. White, he's got nine. Colts trail it, 29-14. And we've got a timeout on the court. With 9:17 to go first half. National Par 29, Colts 14, back in a moment on ed88radio.com.
Wade Cassatot Physical Therapist Assistant and Occupational Therapy Assistant programs in Ashdown are designed to give our students the skills needed to be job ready in only 30 months. At UA Cassatot, our instructors are knowledgeable and experienced. Our classes are affordable and small, and our facilities are big and well-equipped. And you'll find our graduates on the job all over the four states area. And that's something to celebrate. Application deadline is March 1st. UA Cassatot, your career starts here.
Colts trail at 25-14. Tonight's basketball action on NADARadio.com is being brought to you by the good folks at Farmers Bank and Trust.
Your season of life, you'll find the financial products, digital tools, and friendly service that make you feel right at home with Farmers Bank. Come home to Farmers Bank.
Well, we're back courtside. Colts trail it 25-14, or 29-14. As we're about midway through the first half, actually 9:17 remaining in this first half. Lauren Hinton courtside. Tonight's action being brought to you by AEP Swepco. Man, they've been busy the past few days with all the ice and ice scares we've had over the past week. Thankful to the folks that keep our power on at AEP Swepco. Colts have it. Ball stolen away. Nice defensive move that time by the Nighthawks. Driving the other way. Laid it up and in. Was Sadiq Canty. Canty, nice defense, and he finished well. He's got five. Colts trail it by 17. Very talented National Park team, and they can get ahead in a hurry. As that shot underneath by Wally will not go. Swift grabs a rebound. Gets it ahead to White, right side, three-pointer on the way. And Canty puts it up and in. Another three-pointer for Sadiq. He's got a pair of threes, 8 points in the ball game. The Colts have the ball stripped away. Ball goes out of bounds, last touch by National Park. As the Colts get set to make some substitutions here. Like Eddie Gonzalez is going to check in, the seven-footer for the Colts. Also coming in for UA Costout will be Nick Moyer back into the lineup. Demaje Hampton's out there. Also in the lineup, Edwin Aquino for the first time tonight. As the inbounds pass goes to Kahari Loggins. Loggins out beyond the arc, tries to attack, instead gets it out to Aquino. He'll fire up the three, in there! Instant offense from Edwin Aquino coming off the bench, burying the three. Colts down by 17, 34-17. National Park put some points on the board in a hurry in a short span. Underneath, National Park had to bring it right back out again. They couldn't get loose underneath. Three-pointer from the corner on the way in there. And the shot put up and in by Anthony Swift. Swift with the three, 37-17. Colts down by 20. As Loggins has it stolen away. Let's see. Whistling a foul on the steal. Personal foul is going to be called against Madison Pister. Pister called for the personal foul. More like Pester. He was a pest on that steal. Colts get it back, however. Aquino has it in the backcourt. Crosses a horsey head, gets it in the hands of Demaje Hampton. Hampton back out to Gonzalez. And I know if you're watching him play, you're thinking he's a seven-footer, but he's really a three-point shooter. That time, that pass into the backcourt. Keno couldn't get to it, and the Colts turned it over. Unforced error. Colts down by 20, 37-17, 7:22 to go in the first half. National Park, catch and release, turnaround shot, no. Rebound, Aquino has it. Edwin will bring it into the front court, looking for some movement offensively. Fake the three instead, right back to Aquino. Gets it back out to Gonzalez, back to Edwin. Ed backs it out, gets it to Maje Hampton underneath, turnaround shot is blocked, but a whistle and a foul will be called on Tim Quang. Quang called for the personal foul, that's his first. At the free throw line will be Demaje Hampton. Hampton, it'll be his first trip to the free throw line tonight. Colts 4 out of 6 at the charity stripe. Hampton with 4 points in the ball game. Make it 5 as that one is up and in. 37-18, 6:56 to go in this first half. Hampton's second shot, it's on the way, and it is good. So Demaje has 6 points, and the Colts trail it by 18, 37-19. With the basketball, that's Pister. Pister gets it to McCavion White. Attacks the lane, gets it down low on the baseline, loose ball. Oh, good defense that time on the part of Loggins. Managed to come up with a loose ball, but he's called for traveling over there. White will make the inbounds pass. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Nighthawks have it. They'll work it down low. Shot put up, won't go. Rebound tipped around and goes in. Things are going right, they're going right. Basket by Quang. Colts have it. Into the lane. That's Aquino, comes right back out with it. In the hands of Kahari Loggins, drives down. Puts it up from the left-hand side, banks it off the glass and good. Loggins, he's got 6. He's tied with Demaje Hampton for high point honors for the Colts with 6 each. 39-21. White dishes back in the corner. They give it right back to White underneath. Shot put up by Swift, up and in. Anthony Swift with 7. Give White the assist. Colts trail by 20. 41-21. Aquino has it. Gets it out on the perimeter. As Moye tries to attack the baseline, has that shot blocked. One of the leading shot blocking teams in America tonight as the Nighthawks come in. I think they're like 7th in the country in blocked shots. Ball is knocked away, and let's see. Ball went out. Personal foul is going to be called on Swift. Anthony Swift called for the personal foul. That's his 2nd. And heading to the free throw line will be Edwin Aquino. On a lighter night, at some point tonight, I'm going to call somebody Taylor Swift, because it's Taylor Harrell at number 1 on the roster. Right below him is Anthony Swift, number 2. So at some point, I'm inadvertently going to say Taylor Swift, if I haven't done so already. At the free throw line, Edwin Aquino. He's got 3 points. His first trip to the free throw line tonight. Takes his time. Sends it on the way and is good. Edwin has 4. 41-22. Aquino will have another shot coming here. Colts trail it with 5:25 to play in this first half. Edwin's 2nd shot. He's got 4. That one would not go down, and the rebound is going to be pulled down by Quang. To Bryant Hill, gets it down low. Quang has his shot. Block, they're going to call jump ball. Possession error belongs to the Colts. Again, Kahari Loggins in the right place, right time. Colts will have an opportunity to cut into this 19-point lead. They'll get across the midcourt stripe. They get it to Loggins. He wants to go inside. Lost the handle. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Nighthawks. In there trying to make that steal was Corinne Collins. Colts will have it deep in the corner. And Aquino will make the inbounds pass on the baseline. Aquino, Gonzalez, Loggins, Moye, and Wally in the lineup for the Colts. And they're going to wipe up some perspiration there with 21 seconds on the shot clock. 5:04 to go, first half. Colts trailing 41-22. Aquino gets it in to Wally. Wally looking, would like to find Gonzalez, trying to get some separation. As Wally drives, gets it off to Loggins' baseline. That shot will not go. Kwong is there to grab that rebound. And the Nighthawks will bring it the other way. Deep in that left corner. Step back three on the way, in and out, no good. Rebound, Loggins. Loggins to Aquino. Aquino into the front court. Pulls up, gets it out to Wally. Q. Inside it goes to Loggins. Battling, puts it up. Got the shot he wanted. Loggins does a good job down low. He's got eight. 41-24. Shot put up, right side, won't go. Rebound, Loggins grabs it again. Loggins in the open court. Goes around his man. Drew the contact. No call, however. And the rebound comes off to the Nighthawks. They'll drive inside the lane. No call on that end either as the Nighthawks come away with it. And getting the shot up and in, the one-hander inside the lane. That's Jabrian Hill. He's got five. Colts down by 19 again. 43-24. And the officials separate the two. As Moye, Kwong are discussing who should have that basketball. And we'll see. Official says the personal foul is going to be on number three. That would be Jabrian Hill. That's his first. And to the free throw line for the Colts will be Nick Moye. Demaje Hampton is checked in, so it's Moye Hampton, Aquino, Wally, and somebody else. Like, is Loggins still in there? He's over on the bench, but apparently he's going to stay in the game. All right. So Moye will shoot a couple here again. Get that perspiration up off the court. I'm just glad basketball's an indoor sport. Man, it's been absolutely miserable around here the last 10 days or so. At least the temperature was up a little bit. I honestly don't know how people live in Minnesota. 3:44 to go, first half. As Moye will step to the free throw line. Nick on the night. Send it on the way, up and in. So Moye gets his first point of the night. Colts now 8 out of 10 at the free throw line tonight. Moye's second shot, it's on the way, and it's in and out, no good. And the rebound is pulled down by the Nighthawks. Jabrian Hill will work it into the front court. 3.5 minutes to play as the ball stripped away. But a whistle and foul, that's going to be on Kevon Wally. Q call for the personal foul. Wally has picked up his first personal. And Jabrian Hill will head to the free throw line. Hill with 5 points in the free throw line, but this is his first trip to the free throw line tonight. Jabrian's first shot on the way. Got it to go. Shooter's roll that time. Hill now with 6. Eight out of 10 at the free throw line, making 8 out of 11 now. the Nighthawks as a team, as Hill's second shot would not go. Colts have it. As Wally tries to go baseline, kicks it back out into the hands of Aquino. Thought about it, gave it to Loggins at the last second. Loggins kisses it off the glass and good. Loggins has 10. Give Aquino the assist. Loggins on defense. Bounce pass through, picked up by Moye. Gets it ahead to Wally, right back to Moye. And he's going to be fouled on the shot. Wound up on the court, but he's okay. We'll see, the personal foul is going to be called against Patrick Punch. Punch called for his first personal foul. And Moye will head to the free throw line. 44-27, Colts down by 17. 3:03 to play, first half. National Park, 15-0 on the season. Number one team in the country in Division II JUCO basketball. As that first shot by Moye is up and in. He's 2 out of 3 at the free throw line tonight. At the line, second shot by Moye's up and in. So Nick now, 3 out of 4 on the evening. Colts trail at 44-29. Like to get a little run before halftime right here. Can't make it all up at once. Punch has it out beyond the arc. Gets it back to Jabrian Hill. And down low, baseline, shot put up, shot put in. Big guy inside, gets the basket, and a whistle and a foul. He's going to the free throw line to try to complete the three-point play. Personal foul is going to be on Demaje Hampton. Hampton's third personal foul. And at the free throw line, Taylor Harrell. Harrell with 6. It's his first trip to the free throw line tonight. He knocks it down. Taylor's got 7. Colts down by 18. 47-29. 2.5 minutes to go. First half. Moye has it. He'll fire up the three from the left side. Can't get it to go. Colts have yet to hit a three-pointer. Aquino did hit one off the bench. Coming all the way, laying it up. Shot no good. And collision down low, and the whistle is going to be on. We'll see. I know Wally was there. We'll see. They'll discuss it and see who this foul is on. But that is on Wally. We'll see. Wally's only got 1. I'm sorry. No, actually, that's going to be on Moye. Moye's called for his first personal foul. Head to the free throw line will be Jabrian Hill. So Hill heads to the free throw line. He's got 6 points in the ball game, 1 out of 2 at the free throw line this evening. Now, apparently, they're discussing something. And they'll come back and discuss it. So the foul was on. They're going to say it's on Hampton. No. If that's the case, that would be his 4th, I do believe. So Hampton's going to come out. That is his 4th. At the free throw line, Jabrian Hill knocked his first one down. He's got 7 points in the ball game. Colts down by 20 as that one's up and good. 49-29. Looks like Gonzalez back in the lineup for the Colts. Wally's pass picked up by Moye. Almost lost his balance over there. Moye beyond the arc. Tries to attack, lost the handle. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Colts will reset the offense with Wally. Gets it to Loggins, deep in the right corner. 3-pointer on the way by Gonzalez. Can't get the shot to go. Rebounds get a brand new 20. The Colts get a brand new 20. 3-pointer on the way by Wally, no good. Out of bounds. And the Nighthawks have it. leading 49-29 with a minute 42 to play in the first half. It's Bryant Hill with the ball. He'll get it into the hands of Collins. Into Nikavion White. Turnaround shot inside the paint. Won't go. Rebound out of bounds. And the Colts get it back. Minute 24 to go. First half. Colts down by 20. 49-29. Kevon Wally has his pass tipped away. And let's see here. White almost had that steal. Ball goes out of bounds in front of the scorer's table. Colts will retain possession as Wally has it. They work it left side to Aquino. Aquino with it. Spins. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Pass down low. There's Loggins. Puts it up and in. Loggins has been a bright spot tonight. He's got a dozen for the Colts. They trail at 49-31 under a minute to play first half. Nighthawks as White has it stolen away. Wally bringing it the other way. Gets it off to Aquino. Reverse layup. Can't get it to go, but the rebound, or the, there's a whistle and a foul on the drive. He's heading to the free throw line here. And the personal foul is going to be called on Collins. Corinne's called for his third personal foul. And going to the free throw line will be Edwin Aquino. Aquino, 1 out of 2 at the free throw line tonight. He's got 4 points off the bench. He'll be shooting a pair here with 39.4 to go in this first half. Colts down by 18. Shots on the way, and it is good. Aquino with 5. And checking out the lineup will be Collins. Checking back in his place will be Canty. Sadig comes into the lineup. In place, Corinne Collins. Shot by Aquino. On the way, and it's good. So Edwin knocks it down. He's got 6. 37 seconds to go in this first half. 10-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Driving through the lane, that's Hill trying to draw the foul. Inside, Hill comes out of there with it. Kicks it right back out for 3. Colts couldn't come up with a loose basketball. They got it in the hands of White, and Nikavion put it up and in. Colts down by 19, 52-33 is a shot inside the lane by Wally. Won't go. Jabrian Hill with a rebound. Coming the other way, 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Three-pointer on the way, good. Canty hit his third three of the first half, and we've come to the end of the first half of play. Our score, National Park 55, Colts 33. We're back in a moment with some halftime stats here on ed88radio.com.
And what if I want to change my plan?
State Farm's here to help.
What if I want to change sports?
Newcomer Chris Paul is maintaining a narrow lead in these final meters, but here comes an opponent closing the gap. 1 foot in front of the other, they are battling it out. And Chris Paul edges ahead. Those are the hips of a champion.
At State Farm, we're there for your what ifs. Get a quote today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Salinas Satellite Service into Queen is a corporate partner of Ed 88. Salinas is a Southwest Arkansas Dish Network provider offering all the latest package deals. And if you should encounter a problem, Salinas' experienced service technicians are just a phone call away. The very latest in Dish Network home entertainment equipment can be found at Salinas Satellite in downtown DeQueen.
in the city of light. And the best street brings in the neon light. When I heard the thunder, I could feel the rain. It's the same to me, just different name.
Colts trail it at the half, 55-33, as National Park, the number one team in America in Division II JUCO basketball, came in. Along about the 10-minute mark, they pushed that lead to 17. The closest the Colts have been since then has been 15, and they trailed by 22 at the half, as National Park is led by Nikavion White with 12 points in that first half, including a couple of three-pointers. Coming off the bench to hit three three-pointers and finish the first half with 11 points to Dig Canty. Also 8 points in the first half for Jabriant Hill. 7 points each for Anthony Swift and Taylor Harrell. Looks like 6 points in the first half for Patrick Punch and 2 points each for Corinne Collins and Tim Kwong of the Nighthawks. By the way, the only player with any foul trouble whatsoever for National Park is Collins. He's got three personal fouls. Colts, on the other hand, they're led by Kahari Loggins, who has been a bright spot tonight. He's got a dozen points, even though inside he's giving up some height inside. He's got a lot of hustle, got some good, nice moves to the basket, and he winds up the first half with 12 points. Looks like 6 points in the first half for Demaje Hampton, who, by the way, also has four personal fouls. Edwin Aquino came off the bench. He's got 6 points, including the only three-pointer the Colts have hit thus far tonight. And also scoring in that first half, 3 points for Kevon Wally, three for Nick Moye, and three for Zion Harper. Colts are 12 out of 16 at the free throw line, while the Nighthawks, also shooting pretty well at the charity stripe, they're 12 out of 15. And we're still about 10 minutes away from the start of the second half, so we're going to hear a little bit about our adult education classes on our Dirks campus here at halftime, where the Colts trail the Nighthawks 55-33 on ed88radio.com.
To our CCUA adult ed campus here in Dirks, my name is Henrella Lawrence, and I'm the GED instructor at this site. Well, here at Dirks, we have the larger classroom, which is the front one that we're very proud of. A lot of the businesses here uses that. Weyerhaeuser uses it more than possibly the any other. They use the kitchen area when this is not big enough for, and they want to do workshops. They go into the community side and they do their workshops in there. And then they have the kitchen facilities, which makes it real easy. We have a lot of class reunions in there. There are two offices here for instructors. There's seven computers here. We did have 10, but they're just eventually, we're just going to replace them eventually. We work with the local businesses. We've tested for Weyerhaeuser some. We work with students or people just come in needing to build a resume. We have different programs that we can put you in that will take you all the way through doing mock interviews, all the way up to building a resume. And we have people that contact either the college or the facility and let them know if there's jobs available in our area, and that's a plus, I think. I have worked with people from Weyerhaeuser just getting some of their credentials, reviewing them maybe for tests and such like that until they could get their credentials renewed. We've had people that have gone through and got their CDL classes now have good jobs, and this is a plus, I feel like, for our program. Our office hours at this site are very flexible because I'm a single person and therefore I can move with the flow of the students. Whichever will accommodate the most of our students, I try to build a schedule around there and My boss has been very good about always working so that we could reach out to as many students as possible. Right now, we're working with 16, 17-year-olds and with some adults. Our present class is Tuesdays and Thursdays from 9 to 12. We teach subject matter. Our primary program is the GED. We have multiple programs that we can use here at the site if they don't have internet available. Essential Ed, we have the WAGE program. The WAGE program is something that we are required to put all of our students in when they came in, whether they're adults or young people. It encouraged them to get them job ready. And as they go through the program, they earn certificates depending on what they... One of the requirements is that they work on their GED. But then all during this time, it's exposing them to what they would experience on a job, much like our Youth Build program did, except they're not just getting that on training, but it gives them this one that gives us the mock interview, tells them what to look out for, you know, in the business world and how to locate a job. And it's just a wonderful program that promotes workforce so they can, once they get out, they can either go into secondary education or they are be job ready. We just have bukus of information that we can use to help them to set new goals. A lot of 16, 17-year-olds don't know exactly what they want to do. We try to encourage them through our career ladders and see what they might be interested in and help them in this area to set new goals and to become a more productive and happier citizen when they get their GED, because it opens doors to many, many different facets of life. We do have people that will come in just off the street that maybe they just need help with a job application, and so we try to help them that way. But we do have programs where we do a mock interview so that if it's a young person and they don't know how to reach out, or maybe some of the questions that they should be able to answer, well, we can lead them through that. And as they go through the WAGE program, they get certificates so they end up with a resume that's completed that's suitable for taking to their employer should they find a job that they thought they'd be happy in. But the best part of our program, I guess, is the fact that it's free. There's not many things in life that are free. And it's a wonderful program. I enjoy and love it. It's the most rewarding program I've ever been a part of. And we'd love for them to come by and visit our site and see what we have to offer and what we can do to help them.
I'm Barbara Dixon, and this is Anna Belcher, and we're with Southern Bancorp Bank. Southern is a different kind of bank. We are a designated community development financial institution, and our main focus, our mission, is to be involved in and serve the community. And what makes us different is we offer traditional banking services, but we also offer other services that help strengthen our community to teach them financial literacy and to help them to build credit, understand credit, and to make good, wise choices. Some of the programs we offer, we have a learning center that covers everything from savings to loans to small business, housing. There's also a section of that website that is designated for youth that's broken up by age groups, so you can get financial literacy information for your children on that website. There's a section for senior citizens as well. We also offer free credit review. We will help you pull your free credit report, go over it with you, give you the resources to review it and to know what to look for. We offer a credit builder CD loan to help you start building credit history or to improve your credit history. We also offer free counseling services, whether you want to just do a budget or just ask questions. That service is free, and it's all free to customers and non-customers alike. We offer free home ownership counseling services. We offer free income tax preparation through the VITA program. It's a voluntary income tax preparation assistance program. And for consumers who qualify, we prepare their taxes free. We will be doing that right here in the Larkspur branch.
a lot of what Southern does is they try to strengthen the community, the businesses and individuals a lot, and we are considered, one of our models is to be wealth builders for everyone. And one of the primary ways we start that is by teaching savings habits. And Anna is going to tell you a little bit about some of those.
We have a few savings products that's going on right now. One is our Roundup Savings. Every time you use your debit card, you can either round up to the next dollar amount, or you can round up a certain dollar, whether it's one or five, just whatever is convenient for you. And we also have what is called an app that you can download, and the app is called Envy. And it is a savings game. It's 100 days process, and you determine how much you want to save in 100 days. And every day that you go into the app, you open the envelope, and it may transfer a dollar, it may transfer $2. Whatever is in that envelope on that app that day is how much it transferred to your savings account. We also have what we call a CD credit builder loan. If you are just starting out and getting credit, or you've just graduated from school and you're having a hard time getting credit because you have no credit score, or even if you've had past negative credit, then you can come in and we can start you out with credit of a CD loan, and that also gives you a CD. When you pay your loan off, that CD is your money. And Southern believes in Sevier County. We believe in empowering our community, and we are thankful to be here in Sevier County, and we look forward to serving Sevier County and the people in this community for years to come.
Salinas Satellite Service in DeQueen is a corporate partner of Ed 88. Salinas is a Southwest Arkansas Dish Network provider offering all the latest package deals. And if you should encounter a problem, Salinas' experienced service technicians are just a phone call away. The very latest in Dish Network home entertainment equipment can be found at Salinas Satellite in downtown DeQueen.
Like we're about underway here. Set to get things underway in the second half here at the Bank of Oxford Historic Gymnasium, where National Park leads UA Casa Tide 55-33. Nighthawks get the basketball to start the second half. It's Bryant Hill with it into the front court, working out there against Kevon Wally. Three-pointer on the way. Nighthawks can't get it to go. Dylan Glover grabs that rebound. Colts on the run. Deep it. Working the baseline. Kahari Loggins takes right up where he left off in the first half. He's got 14. Colts down by 20. 55-35. Nighthawks work it. Jabrian Hill. He'll fire up the three. Knocks it down. Jabrian Hill with his second three-pointer of the night? Yes. Coming the other way. They tried the alley-oop on the fast break there. A little bit too tall that time for Patrick Punch. Couldn't come down with it. And the Colts will have it back. Trailing 56-35. 18:45 to play in the ball game. Wally pulls up, 14-footer, won't go. The rebound fought for, and the rebound goes out of bounds, last touched by the big guy in the middle. That's Taylor Haler, Harrell, excuse me. So as we wipe up some perspiration out in outside the arc, on the court for the Colts, Kevon Wally, along with Zion Harper. Also out there is Kahari Loggins and Nick Moyer and Dylan Glover. the original starting five, with the exception of Damaje Hampton, who is on the bench right now with four personal fouls. As Loggins gets inside the lane, nice give underneath, and he is going to be fouled by the Nighthawks, Harrell. Taylor Harrell called for the personal foul. Harper's a big kid. Harrell is a mountain. It's his first. And the Colts will have it on the baseline. Fresh 20 on the shot clock. As Wally gets it way out front to Moye. Colts would like to find somebody that could hit some threes here. They're going to have to get that perimeter game going at some point. They made one three in that first half. It wasn't for lack of trying, as that shot would not go by Wally. Rebound comes off to White, and Akavion works it down court. Three-pointer in the corner on the way. Punch a shot. He couldn't punch it in, and it was Loggins who came away with the rebound. He's going to be fouled by Taylor. Taylor Harrell called for the personal foul. It's his second. Loggins, again, another rebound. Loggins having another good night. Long three-pointer on the way by Dylan Glover. That one won't go, and the rebound comes off to White. Nikavion with it in the backcourt, gets around the defender. Gets around both defenders, splits defenders, gives it off to... That would be Collins underneath, but he's going to be fouled on the shot. And that personal foul is going to be called on Kahari Loggins. Loggins' first personal foul, heading to the free throw line, will be Corinne Collins. Collins, 2-for-2 at the free throw line tonight. As a team, we said they were 12 out of 15 in the first half. That one is up and good. Collins, he's got 3 points now. Second shot by Collins, it's good. Colts trail at 60-35 with just under 18 minutes to play in the game. Wally, bounce pass. Left side, free throw line elbow there. In the corner to Wally. Wally back out to Moye. The Loggins working. Dumps it down low, looking for Harper. Harper couldn't control it, and coming the other way, traveling is a call against the Nighthawks. So Colts will get it back. Colts will put it in play in front of their own bench. Loggins to Harper. He gets to Wally. Wally's pass tipped away and chased down by Ja'Bryant Hill. Stripped away again by the Colts. Coming the other way, a reaching foul is going to be on Bryant. Tried to cut off Wally. Bryant, I said Ja'Bryant Hill, that is. That's his third personal foul. Apparently it's his second personal foul. Just giving that to somebody else. Giving a foul to him that belongs to somebody else. Bounce, nice pass through the lane. Give Wally the basket, but what a pass that time by Glover. Wally gets the basket, he's got five. Colts down 60-37. Down low, shot put up by Harrell is up and in. Taylor with a basket. He's got nine. Colts down by 25, 62-37. Wally over to Loggins. Kahari drives strong to the basket. Charging foul on Loggins. That's his second. Nighthawks get it back. Colts will put a little bit of pressure in the backcourt. Ja'Bryant Hill up the far sideline. Oh, nice give that time to Harrell, but he can't complete the play. Coming the other way. That's Wally. Takes it all the way. And a whistle and a foul. As Wally's going to the free throw line, we'll see who they give this to. And we got a couple of players to choose from right here. And they're going to give it to Ryan Hill. That is his third. Brian said, wait a minute. You sure? And they're going to count the basket. Yes, they're going to call goaltending, I guess. The shot didn't go in, did it? I didn't think it did. Wally's got 9. Make it 10 as that one's up and in. I said 9. No, he's got 8 in the ball game. Colts trail at 62-40. Hill takes it all the way through, gets it back on free throw line. Shot put up and in by Patrick Punch. Punch knocks it down. He's got 8. Nighthawks will pick up the pressure at midcourt. Wally, bounce pass, left side. Loggins gets it over to Glover. Glover out to Wally. Right side it goes. Glover's long three-pointer. No good. Air ball picked up by White. Nikavion. Underneath, shot put up by Harrell. Taylor Harrell, he's got 11. Colts down 66-40. Wally gets it back to Moye. Trying to work. Had Harper open for a moment. Glover gets it back. As a pass inside, tipped away, picked up. And a nice bounce pass coming the other way. Behind the back, pass by White into the hands. A punch, and there's so many weapons, so many different ways to hurt you. National Park up 68-40. Timeout with 15:02 to go in the ball game. We're back after this.
Coca-Cola Zero Sugar. Is it the best Coke ever?
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
Okay, I'm gonna try it first.
Yes!
I need to try it first.
Colts trail it. 68-40. Another solid performance from National Park. As we pointed out a couple of times tonight, they are the top-ranked team in junior college Division II basketball in America. And they show why. Inside, outside, they defend well. They create offense off of their defense at times. Or they can set it up and put it in. Wally works it deep in the right corner. Hampton has it after that Colts timeout. Actually, that's Moye in the corner. Down low, they get it to Hampton. DiMaggio in the lineup with 4 personal fouls. Tried to dump it down low to Loggins. Kahari working hard, puts it up and in. Blue collar basket on the part of Kahari Loggins. Quickly the other way, Nighthawks take it all the way. Jabrian Hill snuck by everybody and got the basket. He's got 13. Colts down 70-42. Wally works it left side. In the lineup for the first time tonight for the Colts, that's Ryan Clemens. And we're at left side. Loggins looking alone underneath. DiMaggio puts it up and in. Hampton with the basket. He's got 8. Colts down 70-44. Collins. They'll work it quickly around the perimeter all alone up front. Brian Hill couldn't get that one to go. Wally grabs a rebound. The Colts, opportunity for back-to-back baskets here. Three-pointer on the way by Clemens. Won't go, but the rebound out of bounds. Last touch by Harrell. No. They're going to say it's off the Colts. The official on the baseline. Play was he was behind the play. Deferred to the official across the way. And he said it came off of the Colts. Nighthawks have it. Jabrian Hill attacks, pulls up, free throw line, drops it in. Makes it look easy. Jabrian Hill now, he's got 15 in the ball game, 7 of them here in the first 6 minutes and change of this second half. Wally backs it back out. They work it left side. Yeah, loose ball goes out of bounds and last touched by the Nighthawks. They got a couple of players down on the court right now. Everybody's good, though. They were looking for Ryan Clemens on that side. So the Colts will get it back. I'm going to mop things up over here. Take a little break here with 13:04 to go in the ball game. As they continue to work on the court out there. Colts will make the inbounds pass. And fire it way out front to get it to Nick Moyer in the backcourt. Works it left side to Wally. Q works around the screen by Hampton, goes all the way, has that shot blocked. I think that was Swift that got up there and knocked it down. Anthony Swift with a block. And the Nighthawks have it. Jabrian Hill works around the screen by Swift. Swift breaks it off towards the basket. Bounce pass intended for Swift, but it went out of bounds. Last touch by Swift. Pass was a little bit behind him. Colts will get it back. Eddie Gonzalez is going to come in for Kahari Loggins. So it's Gonzalez and Hampton along with Clemens. Wally drives all the way, shot blocked again. Jabrian Hill coming the other way, gets it ahead to Swift, and he swiftly puts it down. Anthony Swift with 9 points in the ballgame. Colts trail at 74-44, 30-point deficit, biggest lead of the night for the Nighthawks. Hampton attacking the batter. Actually, that's Moyer attacking the basket, and he will be fouled. They're going to call that one on Swift. That'll be his third. And heading to the free throw line for the Colts. Will be Nick Moyer. Moyer sends it on the way, and it's in there. Took a little bit, but it finally went down. Moyer, 4 points in the ball game, 4 out of 5 at the free throw line tonight. Nick will have another one coming here. It's a second shot. It's on the way, and it's in there. Colts cut it back to 28. 74-46. Gavion White works it deep in the left corner. Swift puts it up, can't get it to go. Rebound comes off to Wally. Q on the attack. Ahead to Swift, Nick Moyer, deep in that left corner. Shot on the way by Clemens, won't go, and the rebound comes off to the Nighthawks. Pass in traffic, picked off by the Colts. Coming the other way, Wally goes strong to the basket. No call down low. Wally is down on the court. Tip in was no good. And no call on this end either. I think that's a makeup no call right there. Wally is on the court, holding the back of his head. Got a timeout on the court right now. And we'll take a quick timeout right now with our score. National Park 74, Colts 46. Back in a moment on ed88radio.com.
Wow, this new Coca-Cola Zero Sugar, is it the best Coke ever?
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
Okay, I'm gonna try it first.
Yes!
I need to try it first.
We're back. Kevon Wally is up, and he's staying in the lineup. As National Park will put the ball in play on the baseline. Looks like Nick Moyer is going to come out, and Dylan Glover will return to the lineup. So it's Clemens, Glover, Gonzalez, Hampton, and Wally in the lineup. Loose ball picked up by National Park. Shot no good. Hampton with the rebound. DiMaggio gives it off to Q. Wally into the front court. Left side. Colts drive it. Pass tipped out of bounds. Dylan Glover's pass. Intended for Ryan Clemens. Tipped out of bounds. Clemens is going to come out, as will Glover. Looks like Aquino back in the lineup. Also, Moyer, along with Wally and Gonzalez. Gonzalez takes the inbounds pass. Little fall away, 14-footer's good. Eddie gets the two-pointer, his first two of the night. Colts down, 74-48. Gonzalez comes out on Jabrian Hill. Left side, Swift's three-pointer, can't go. Rebound, DiMaggio Hampton, he'll get it to Aquino. Edwin on the run. Right side, now back out front to Aquino. They'll set the offense. Wally has it. Baseline, that's Hampton, goes inside. He's going to be fouled by Swift. Anthony Swift called for the personal foul. And for Swift, that will be his fourth personal foul. Colts will have it on the baseline, trailing 74-48 with 10:37 to play in the game. Colts need to get it in. Wally gets it way out to Gonzalez. Eddie to Aquino. Edwin right back to Eddie Gonzalez for three. That one is an air ball out of bounds. National Park. Kavion White almost has it stolen away. Manages to come out of there with it. Gets it to a teammate. Didn't give up on the play. Left side. Oh, nice move inside the lane. Shot put up and in by National Park's Canty. Sadiq Canty. He's got 13 points in the ballgame. His first two of the second half. Colts down 76-48. As Wally drives all the way. Shot blocked by Swift. I don't know how many block shots Anthony has tonight. I know it's at least four. Colts will try it again underneath their own basket, trailing 76-48, 9:54 to go in the ball game. So Wally will make the inbounds pass, get way out to Gonzalez. Gets it over to Moyer. Moyer almost knocked down as he was going in the lane, no call. Hampton gets the rebound, however, and puts it up and in. I think sometimes when the game gets a little one-sided, officials don't blow the whistle near as often. That was pretty obvious. Shot at the free throw line, up and in. Patrick Punch knocks it down. He's got a dozen for the Nighthawks. 78-50, Colts down by 28 points. As Moyer pulls up from three-point land, and the Colts have their second three-pointer of the night. The first for Nick Moyer.
That coming with 9:15 to play in the ball game. Demaje Hampton's coming out of the lineup, as will Eddie Gonzalez. Also, Edwin Aquino's coming out. Looks like Terry Gupton, along with Nick Moye, the Colts also have Zion Harper in there, along with Wally, that is. And also in the lineup for the Colts is Dylan Glover. Pass through the lane, tipped around, stolen away by Kevon Wally. Q with it into the front court. Colts down 78-53. Behind the back dribble, shot in the lane by Moye is up and in. Moye gets the basket. He's got seven coming the other way. Swift gets the basket on the other end. That was so quick. He's got 13. You might even say it was swift. Not just quick, it was swift. Colts have it. Gupton gets it to Harper. Muscles his way inside, puts it up. Can't get the shot to go. McCavion White with it. Coming the other way. Nice give on the baseline, and Swift gets another one. What a dish that time by White. 15 points for Swift, but give White the assist. Colts to Gupton. To Glover. Dylan, bounce pass through the lane, coming the other way. Wally gets the easy basket. Q now with seven. Make that 10. He's got seven in the second half. Colts down 82-57, 7:45 to play in the ball game. Swift will fire it up from three, knocks it down. Anthony Swift has got 11 points in the second half, 18 points in the ball game. Colts trail at 85-57. And the ball stolen away, coming the other way with it. Glover's going to be called for the personal foul, as Punch had stolen it away, was making his way for the basket. He will be fouled. And head to the free throw line will be Patrick Punch. Yes, that personal foul is going to be on Dylan Glover. That's his third. At the free throw line is Patrick Punch. He's got a dozen points in the ballgame. Two out of four at the free throw line tonight. Make it three out of five as that one's up and in. Second shot, it's on the way, and it is good. Punch now with 14. Colts down 87-57. Nighthawks equal their biggest lead of the night at 30 with 7:18 to go in the ballgame. Left side, Wally. Wally working up top. That's a whistle and a foul. And that will be the second personal foul on Sadig Canty. Call for the personal foul. And Wally will head to the free throw line. Q on the evening is two out of three at the free throw line. He's got 7 points in the second half, 10 points in the ball game so far. Q, the leading scorer for the Colts on the season, averaging 16 points a ball game. That's number 11 for tonight. Colts down 87-58, 7:08 to go in the game. Second shot, it's good. Colts down 87-59. Swift with it, works it left side. In the hands of Canty. Goes baseline, cuts through the defenders and lays it up and in. Canty with a basket. He's got 15 tonight coming off the bench. Colts in the front court, that's Wally. Wally into the hands of Moye. Tries to attack. Spin move inside. Lays it off the glass and good. Nice spin by Moye for the basket. He's got 9 points in the second half. Colts coming the other way. Gupton lays it up the glass. Pinned to the backboard, and they're going to count the basket.
The basket is up and in. And that is Gupton on the basket. So Terry gets his first two of the night. 89-63, 6:19 to play in the ball game. Colts down. National Park looking to make it 16-0 on the season. As DeBryan Hill makes it look easy, driving through the lane, laying it up and in. DeBryan Hill, 17 points in the ball game. Reese in the lineup. Jordan works it left side. Moye gets it down low to Loggins. Working against Swift, puts it up and in. That's not easy, but Loggins makes it work. He's got 18. Tell you what, Swift is a good defender down low. He's blocked a bunch of shots. Loggins made it work. Little fall away that time on the part of Patrick Punch. Made that one look easy. He's got 10 in the second half, 16 in the ballgame. Colts down 93-65, 5:20 to go in the game. Ball stolen away by White. Reese was able to get a hand on it, but the ball went out of bounds, last touch by the Colts. And the KV on White that time. Got the steal, and he'll make the inbounds pass here. White with a dozen points in the ballgame, all of them in the first half, but he's been very unselfish with the basketball. He's a good player. Brian Hill kicks it back out to Swift. He'll fire up the three and knocks it down. Anthony Swift, he's got 3 3-pointers on the night. He's got 21 points in the ballgame. Colts have it. Trailing 96-65, under 5 minutes to play in the game. Wally works it left side to Reese. Jordan goes inside, puts it up, can't get it to go. The rebound tipped around, picked up by Loggins. He's going to be fouled by Swift. And that should be Anthony's fifth personal foul. So Loggins forcing the issue that time. He'll head to the free throw line. And Swift will come out of the ball game. Wound up with 21 points on the evening. And checking in his place will be Tim Kwong. Also coming out, DeBryan Hill is going to come out of the lineup for National Park. At the free throw line, it's Loggins. Loggins 2 for 2 at the free throw line tonight, and that one make it 3 for 3. He's got 19 points on the ball on the night. Looking for number 20 right here. Colts down 96-66. Kari's got basically a third of the points himself tonight. Second shot's also good. And the Colts trail it by a count of 96-67 with 4.5 minutes to go in the game. Collins has it. Corinne into the hands of White. McCabeon gives it right back to Collins, has it stripped away, picked up. Driving inside the lane, pass, shot, put up, and blocked out of bounds by Demaje Hampton. Canty tried to go in there. National Park will make the inbounds pass. They'll get it to White. White working down low. Moye there defensively, but White kisses it high off the glass and good. Gavian White now, 14 points in the game. Colts trail at 98-67. 4 minutes to go in the game. Wally drives all the way, lays it up and in. Nice effort on the part of Kevon Wally. He only had 3 points at the half, but he's got 10 here in the second half. As the Colts will have it on the far end, trailing 98-69. Looks like White is going to come out of the lineup. Also coming out will be Patrick Punch. Colts, Wally has it. And loose ball on the court. Saved in by National Park, coming all the way to lay it up. Tried to stuff it home. Kwong tried, no luck there. On the other end, Wally on the snowbird puts it up and in. Kevon Wally with a basket. Colts trail it 98-71. National Park looking for the century mark. Kwong down low. Comes underneath, lays it off the glass and good. He gets the basket, and that's the 100 mark right there. Colts working on the perimeter. Reese goes up over the screen, set there by Loggins, puts it up and in. Jordan Reese with a basket, his first two of the night. Colts trail at 100-73. Collins. And they're going to call backcourt on Collins. And he'll come out of the lineup, and checking in his place will be Mondo Watkins. Wondering if we'll get to see Will Dykes for National Park. Played his high school ball at DeQueen High School. Pass underneath. As Wally fires it back out, three-pointer on the way by Moye, no good, rebound. There's Loggins again. Right place, right time. Basket good. 100-75, Colts down by 25 here, and we've got a whistle and a foul. That's going to be on Kahari Loggins. That'll be his third. Loggins, 22 points in the ball game tonight. National Parker have it across the way. They'll get it in. New guy out there is Brody Tucker. Three-pointer on the way, won't go. The rebound, Tucker gets it, fires it back out front. Into the hands, Mondo Watkins. Loose ball on the court, scramble for it. And it goes out of bounds, last touch by the Nighthawks with a minute 56 to go in the ball game. Colts will have it. They'll get it in to Wally. Wally across the timeline. Gets it over to Loggins. Loggins wants to attack as usual. Gets free underneath. And a charging foul going to be called on Kahari Loggins. So Loggins picks up his fourth personal foul. Colts will set up some pressure here. I think Zion Harper is going to check into the lineup. Demaje Hampton or Kahari Loggins comes out. So it's Reese, Moye, Harper, Wally, and Hampton in the lineup for the Colts as they put on some full court pressure here. And in the lineup, Will Dykes for the first time tonight. National Park almost lost it up top. Three-pointer on the way. Air ball out of bounds. Shot that time by Brody Tucker. Colts get it back. Reese has it. A minute 25 to go in the ball game. Colts trailing 100-75. They'll get it out to Wally. Wally inside. Demaje Hampton has that shot blocked. Will Dykes was there. Got a hand on it. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Dykes. National Park. Set up defensively, Colts have it with a minute 12 to go in the game. Fresh 20 on the shot clock. Hampton got the ball. Dykes tried to steal it. He's going to be called for reaching. So Will call for the personal foul. And heading to the free throw line will be Demaje Hampton. Hampton 2-for-2 at the free throw line tonight. He's got 10 points in the ball game. And we're going to see some more faces out there, fresh faces for the Colts. Hampton and Wally will stay in the lineup. Gonzalez and Clemens and Aquino check in for the Colts. At the free throw line, Demaje Hampton puts it up and in. Hampton 3-out-of-3 at the free throw line tonight. Second shot, it's good. National Park on top with a minute 8 to play in the game. The pass tipped away momentarily by Gupton, picked up by the Nighthawks. He'll work out beyond the perimeter. Watkins, Mondo inside the lane. Nice give to Will Dykes. Dykes cuts through. Gets it deep in that right corner. Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound comes off to Clemens. Ryan fires it ahead to Aquino. Edwin dribbles around the defender. Fires it way out. Gonzalez for three. Buries it. 7-foot Eddie Gonzalez with a three. He's got five. Colts cut it to 100-80 with 30 seconds to go in the ball game. Big collision. No call. As a shot was put up and in by Thompson, Colin Thompson. Colts have it inside. Hampton puts it up and in. Hampton's got 8 points in the second half, 14 points in the ballgame. 102-82, 17 seconds to go in the game. Coming the other way, shot high off the glass, no good. And the loose ball is picked up by Aquino. 8 seconds to go in the ballgame. Gonzalez pulls out for three, in there. Eddie Gonzalez with another three. He's got eight, and that should just about do it with 2.8 to go in the ballgame. Final score, National Park 102, Colts 85. We'll be back to wrap it up right after this on N88Radio.com.
If it's an outage, you should report it to SWEPCO using their mobile app. But if you're looking to replace your light bulbs, I have an idea. You should consider changing to LED bulbs. They use at least 75% less energy than traditional bulbs, which means saving you a lot of money. They can also last at least 25 times longer and emit very little heat. You can also get LED bulbs that change color, are remote controlled, and they can even play music. They'll even drive your kids to summer camp. So what are you waiting for? Switch to LED bulbs today.
Final score tonight. Colts come up short, 102-85 to National Park, as the Nighthawks run their record to 16-0 on the season. Colts tonight were led in scoring by Kahari Loggins, who finished the evening with 22 points. 16 points tonight for Kevon Wally, 14 for Damaje Hampton, 12 points tonight for Nick Moye, 8 points in the second half for Eddie Gonzalez, including a couple of late three-pointers in the game. Looks like 6 points in the ballgame for Edwin Aquino. 3 points tonight for Zion Harper and 2 points each for Jordan Reese and Jaden, Gupton, Terry Gupton. Meanwhile, the Nighthawks had a couple of players leading the way. Anthony Swift and Jabriant Hill each with 21 points. Swift, by the way, including, 3 three-pointers in the ballgame for Swift. Looks like 16 points tonight for Patrick Punch. 14 points on the evening for Nikavion White, who had 12 of those in the first half, but spent the second half, he was dishing off to others. Good ball player, that's all I can say. Sadiq Canty came off the bench to hit for 15 tonight, and 11 points tonight for Taylor Harrell. Again, Nighthawks moved their record to 16-0 on the season with that 102-85 victory over the Colts. Now, the next time out for UA Cassatot, we'll be heading to South Arc. Down in El Dorado, South Arkansas, Thursday night. Colts and the Lady Colts will be playing. 5:30 for the ladies, 7:30 for the men, and we'll pass along all the info you need as far as the live stream information is. You'll find that on our Ed88 Facebook page and on the UA Cassatot Basketball Facebook page later on this week. But again, that final score, National Park wins it, 102-85. For all of us at Ed88 Sports, we want to thank you for tuning in. Have a safe evening. Good. Thank you so much. You're good.